नामिने नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रष्टाय भूतले श्रीमते राधानाथ स्वामिनिति नामिने नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्ण प्रष्टाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पश्चात्य देशतारिणे ओम ज्ञानतिमिरांध्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितमेन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरुश्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सकगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवम् साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सकगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च हे कृष्णकरुणासिन्धो दीनबन्धो जगत्पदे गोपेशगोपिकान्त राधाकान्त नमोऽस्तुते सप्तकाञ्चनगौराङ्गी राधे वृन्दावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसूते देवि प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। ईश्वर परम कृष्ण सच्चिदानंद विग्रह अनादिरादिर गोविंद सर्व कारण कारणम हरे कृष्ण। By the constant mercy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, we are nicely studying Bhagavad Gita every day. So by Krishna's constant mercy, we have successfully finished 53 slokas in the 11th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. So that is Vishwarupa, so in the universal form. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, in this chapter, we have understood a lot of things about Krishna's personal form. And especially we have understood about that Krishna's three forms. So there is his Vishwarupa universal form, and also Krishna's Vishnu form, the four-handed form, Chaturbhujena, with four bhujas, four-armed form. And also Krishna's two-armed form, which is so special also, because Arjuna is able to see Krishna's all these forms with his special eyes, with his divine eyes. So that's what we are studying and understanding in this chapter. So in the 10th chapter, very beginning, what Krishna said, Krishna told Arjuna that Name Vidhu Suraganaga Prabhavam na Magarishega. Aham Adirgi Devanam Magarishinam cha Sarvasaga. So even the Maharishis and demigods, they don't know me fully because I am even the beginning of them. That's what Krishna says. So Krishna is the Adir, Krishna is the Anadir. Yoma Majam Anadim cha Veti Loka Mageswaram. So in one shloka, in the tenth chapter, second shloka, Krishna said that he is the Adir. And then in the 10th chapter, 3rd shloka, Krishna is saying that Anadir. So Aham Adirgi Devana Maharishinam cha Sarvasagam. I am the origin of Devas and Maharishis, the demigods and the rishis, everyone. So Krishna is the origin of everyone. And then in the 10th chapter, 3rd shloka, Krishna is saying that Yomam Ajam Anadim cha. So one who understands that I am unborn and anadim. There is no beginning for me. That's what Krishna is saying very, very clearly. Yomam Ajam Anadim cha Veti Loka Maheswaram. So anyone who understands that I am the supreme controller of all planets, Veti Loka Maheswaram, Yomam Ajam Anadimcha. Anyone understands that I am the unborn and I have no origin, no beginning for myself. So that's what Krishna is saying. Yomam Ajam Anadimcha Veti Loka Maheswaram Asamudaga Samar Teshu sarva papai pramuchyate. Anyone who knows, anyone who understands without any doubt that I am the supreme God, basically I am the supreme controller of all planets and I am unborn and I am anadim, I have no beginning, so without any confusion, asammodagam, so he is freed from, liberated from all sinful reactions. Sarva papaihi pramuchyate. So just by knowing that Krishna is the Supreme Lord, Krishna is everything, we are freed from all miseries of material existence. So that's what Krishna is teaching us very, very clearly. So that Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna, it's very difficult to know about him. Out of thousands, only one person will endeavor for perfection. And even among those who are endeavoring for perfection, hardly one knows Krishna in truth. Manushyanam sahasresu kaschit yatati siddhaye yatatamapi siddhanam kaschin mam veti tatvatakam. So manushyanam sahasresu, out of thousands, only one will endeavor for perfection, kaschit yatati siddhi. And out of those who are endeavoring for perfection, yatatamapi siddhanam kaschin mam veti tatvatakam. Only one will know me in truth. So that's what Krishna is saying there. Only one knows me in truth. So that much difficult it is to know about Krishna. So that's what Krishna here is showing all this form, and he is telling Arjuna that no one else has seen this form before that. And we are in this world, in this earth, out of billions of people, there are very few who are interested in studying this Bhagavad Gita. Even if we tell everyone, they will not show interest. Because people are so much in this world, material world, so much entangled, and with so much of other desires and attachments, they don't have any time to
Hare Krishna Guruji.
Okay, so what we are studying about in this material world, people are so much entangled and so much of in this controlled by this Maya that we don't have time to think about Krishna. And we, for us in general, all other things will become very important. So when it comes to remembering Krishna or serving Krishna, so we don't have time in general in this material world. That's what Krishna said, that only one in thousand will endeavor for perfection, and out of them only one in, hardly one knows me in truth. That's what Krishna said. Because in this material world, Maya is so powerful. So Mama Maya Duratya is divine in nature. So it will be like for us, it will be like when we are focused so much on material world, material sense objects, it will be like that way only. But unfortunately, we don't see the truth. The reality, the truth is actually we are actually struggling and suffering in this material world. We are actually going to lose everything at one point of time. Nothing we are gaining to keep with us forever, other than Krishna consciousness, other than this Bhagavad Gita knowledge. So whatever we progress, as many, many times I mentioned in the past, whatever progress we make in serving Krishna, that is the only thing we are going to keep with us forever. That's the only progress, that's the only achievement, it's going to stay with us forever. Other than this, everything else we are going to lose. So that way we have to be intelligent enough to make use of this opportunity and get to know more about Krishna, all about Krishna. We should study and understand all about Krishna. Just with this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So then we will be freed from all miseries of material existence. We'll be freed from all sinful reactions. Sarva papaihi pramuchyati. Sarva papaihi means all papas, all sins. We will be freed from all sins. That's what Krishna is saying. That just by knowing about Krishna, that he's the unborn, he's the eternal, he's the supreme person, he's the source of everything. So everything, just knowing about Krishna, he's the supreme controller of all planets, everything. Just by knowing about Krishna, we are freed from all sinful reactions. And now in the 11th chapter, we know so much more about Krishna, because Arjuna asked Krishna to show the universal form, and Krishna showed the universal form. We understood so much about Krishna, and also about Krishna's four-handed Vishnu form and Krishna's two-armed form, so human form. Everything is so wonderful. Rupam Adbhutam Hari. So Rupam Ati Adbhutam Hari means his form is so wonderful. Ati Adbhutam. Adi Adbhutam means it's so much wonderful. Adi Adbhutam Hari. Krishyami cha punar punar. Krishyami cha muhu muhu. That's what Sanjaya says at the end. So by remembering that, by thinking about that, by remembering that, my hairs are standing on end. And Romaharsascha Jayate, Romaharsha. So Romaharsha. So that's what Sanjaya says at the end. So that much wonderful form Krishna is. So if we know about Krishna, so by Krishna's causeless mercy from this Bhagavad Gita, so then it is so much of happiness for us. It's so much of happiness. So then we will be able to remember Krishna and go back to Krishna as well. So we need to develop that enjoyment, that happiness in remembering Krishna. So then our life will be very nice. So that's what Sanjaya says that, Tatcha samsmritya samsmritya rupam ati adbudam hari vismayome mahan rajan hirshyami cha puna puna. So in the 18th chapter, 77th sloka, Sanjaya is saying that, so rupam ati adbudam hari, so hari is so much wonderful rupam, so ati adbudam hari, so samsmritya samsmritya, by remembering again and again, so I'm enjoying so much. So I'm enjoying so much again and again. That's what he says it. As I remember the wonderful form of Lord Krishna, I'm struck with wonder more and more, and I rejoice again and again. That's what Sanjaya is saying about Krishna's form. So it's all Krishna's mercy he was able to. Even Sanjaya said that, as I repeatedly recall this wondrous and holy dialogue between Krishna and Arjuna, I take pleasure being thrilled at every moment. Rajan samsmritya samsmritya samvada nimam adbhutam kesavarjunayo punyam tirshyami cha muhur muhur. So that way, this wonderful Krishna's form, Krishna's Bhagavad Gita knowledge, all such things, if we study again and again, if we remember this again and again, samsmritya samsmritya punaga punagam, so then our life is going to be so wonderful. Then we are not going to be controlled by the modes of material nature. We will be able to free ourselves from the modes of the material nature. So that kind of attachment we need to develop towards Krishna. So that is possible only by studying this Bhagavad Gita. Only by studying and understanding this Bhagavad Gita again and again, so we are going to develop that attachment, that kind of attachment towards Krishna. Only this Bhagavad Gita knowledge only can bring such changes in us. There is nothing else can do. This Bhagavad Gita knowledge only can make such a big change in our life. In fact, when we study and understand this Bhagavad Gita fully, we will ourselves become engaged in Krishna's service all the time. Even though so many other impediments, other difficulties, other problems may come on the way, but for us, when we are very much attached only to Krishna, then by Krishna's mercy, all such problems, everything will be just like that. It will be removed. Everything will be solved. Everything will happen by Krishna's mercy. So that's why at any point of time, we should not leave Krishna. That's what is very important. We should always stick to Krishna. That is possible only with the Bhagavad Gita knowledge. So the Bhagavad Gita knowledge, if we study and understand it completely, fully, so then nobody can shake our faith. Then we will not change from our path. Then we will definitely make continuous progress, and we'll go to Krishna as well. There is no doubt about it. So that kind of knowledge we are getting in this Bhagavad Gita. And in the universal form also, we understood so much that Krishna is the time, is the destroyer of, great destroyer of the world, and everything is destroyed by Krishna. Because no one can ask the question that why Krishna is giving miseries, why Krishna is testing us. Not like that. The problem, the real problem is with us. Why are we not interested in remembering Krishna? Why are we not interested in going back to Goloka? Why we are so much attached to this material world, material sense objects? Why we cannot give up all this attachment? Why we cannot remember Krishna all the time and surrender unto Krishna? So that is the question we need to ask. We cannot simply ask that why Krishna is testing, Krishna is creating trouble like that. That is not correct. Krishna is not creating trouble to anyone. Krishna is giving us the knowledge. Krishna is very clearly telling us that this is not the place to lead a happy life. Here, no one can live happily. This is not a place for bliss. Here, it is full of miseries. It is full of suffering. So you get out of this place and come to me. That's what Krishna is saying. That you come there, you will be very happy. There are no miseries and you will enjoy there forever. and you don't have to worry about anything. I'll take care of you fully. So Krishna is telling so much. So we should be able to just accept it. So then there are no issues, no miseries. So that is why this Bhagavad Gita knowledge is very important for us, so that we will always depend on Krishna, remember Krishna, serve Krishna, do everything for Krishna with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. If we have Bhagavad Gita knowledge, then only we will do that. With the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, it is definitely possible for us to go to Krishna, there is no doubt about it. It's definitely possible for us to forget everything about this material world, there is no doubt about it. Because if we practice this Bhagavad Gita way to way and follow what Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita in terms of chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, in terms of making prasadam and offering it to Krishna, in terms of controlling our sleep and diet and taking care of our health and all such things, if we just follow Bhagavad Gita, we are on the right path and we will be able to remember Krishna and we will be able to go to Krishna. We will be able to effectively make use of this human body if we have the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. Otherwise, we will misuse this body. This body, if we don't use it to progress towards Krishna, so that means we will use this body to actually make the soul fall under and fall into the hell. So that's what is going to happen. Patanti, narake, asuchau. Patanti, narake, asuchau. Patanti means falling. Narake means naraka, hell. Patanti, narake, asuchau. So that should not happen in this material world. अनेक चित्त विभ्रांत मोह जाल समावृत प्रसक्ता काम भोगेसु पतन्ति नरकेसु छौ. That's what will happen if you don't have the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. If you are too much attached to material sense objects, then अनेक चित्त विभ्रांत, being perplexed with so much of worries, अनेक चित्त, unlimited worries, अनेक चित्त विभ्रांत, मोह जाल समावृतकम, being bound by a network of illusions, that's what मोह जाल समावृतकम. प्रसक्ताग काम भोगेसु, attached to material sense enjoyment, पतंति नरकेसु, we will fall down into the hell, that's what will happen. But with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, that's not going to happen. Because with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, we are going to develop attachment to Krishna and we will become a devotee of Krishna with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. That's why Krishna is saying that ज्ञानी तो आत्मैव मे मतम उदाराग सर्व एवैते आस्तितक सहि युक्तत्व मामेवानुक्तमाम गति. सो दि ज्ञानी ही इज ऑलवेज मामेवानुक्तमाम गति, ही कीप्स मी एज हिज डेस्टिनेशन. दैट्स व्हाट कृष्णा इज सेइंग दैट. सो ज्ञानी तो आत्मैव मे मतम आस्तितक सहि युक्तत्व, दैट्स व्हाट कृष्णा इज सेइंग दैट. सो दैट वे वी हैव टू बिकम द ज्ञानी. सो दैट इज ओनली पॉसिबल बाय स्टडीइंग एंड अंडरस्टैंडिंग दिस भगवद गीता, वी विल बिकम ए ज्ञानी. That's what is happening with us. We are becoming jnanis. And Krishna said in the sloka number 53 in the 11th chapter we studied yesterday, the form you are seeing with your transcendental eyes cannot be understood simply by studying the Vedas, nor by undergoing serious penances, nor by charity, nor by worship. It is not by this means that one can see me as I am. That's what Krishna is saying there. So naham vedehi. So it's not possible by Vedas. Not tapasa, not by austerities, not dhanena, not by charities, nachejaya, not by simply worshipping. Sakya evam vidho aham Arjuna, sakya evam vidho drashtum, drashtvanasi mamyata. So whatever you are seeing, it is not possible just by doing all those things. So it is possible only by surrendering unto Krishna. So what we are going to study today in this sloka number 54, so what Krishna is saying very clearly in the next sloka, the sloka what we are studying today. Bhaktyat ananyaya sakya aham evam vidho Arjuna jnatum drashtum cha tatvena praveshtum cha parantapa. That's what Krishna is saying there. Bhaktyat ananya. Bhaktyat ananyaya sakya. So ananya means without any deviation. Bhaktya means devotion. So devotional service. So without any deviation. That's what ananya, sakya. So if anyone, it is possible. Sakya means it is possible. If anyone is able to show unalloyed, unconditional devotion unto me, that's what bhaktyat ananyaya sakya aham eva vidho Arjuna, then they can know me fully in truth. So Krishna can be known as he is only with devotion, not by any other means, only by bhakti. Bhaktyat vananyaya sakya. Aham eva vidojo. So that's what we have to be, a devotee of Krishna. That's what is the ultimate position, top position one can have. So we are very, very fortunate to be a devotee of Krishna. So bhaktyat vananyaya sakya aham eva vidojo. Then only we can understand Krishna and we can see Krishna as he is. Jnatum drashtum cha tatvena praveshtum cha parantapa. We can enter into Krishna's world. Praveshtum. Praveshtum means entering. So enter into Krishna's world. So jnatum drashtum. Jnatum means to know. Drashtum means to see. Praveshtum means to enter into. So we can know and we can see and we can enter into Krishna's will and we can see as he is. We can understand about Krishna fully, completely. Only it is possible only by what? Only by devotion. So that's what Krishna is saying. Bhaktyat vananyaya sakya. Jnatum drashtum. So aham eva vidojana. Jnatum drashtum cha tatvena. Praveshtum cha parantam. My dear Arjuna, only by undivided devotional service can I be understood as I am standing before you, and can thus be seen directly. Only in this way can you enter into the mysteries of my understanding. So that way, by having devotion on Krishna, by remembering Krishna, by studying this Bhagavad Gita, developing that relationship with Krishna, getting ourselves attached to Krishna with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, so only by that unalloyed, unconditional, unalloyed devotion, we can actually go to Krishna's world, Goloka. So what is needed? Only devotion. Nothing else is needed. So Krishna expects from us only devotion. That means love. So Krishna loves us so much and Krishna wants us to love him, of course. Because he loves us so much. And when we don't love him, when we don't remember him. In fact, Krishna is remembering us all the time. That's what is very important. Krishna never forgets us. Krishna is there in our heart as a super soul. He has no other job other than only remembering us. When he is there in our heart as a super soul, Krishna is always overseeing. Krishna is always watching us. Upadrishya anumanta bhakta bhokta mageswaraga paramatme iti chayuktaga vegesmin purushat sabha. But we are only forgetting Krishna and going after materialistic things in this material world, going after the worldly matters. We are only forgetting Krishna, but Krishna is not forgetting us. Krishna is remembering us all the time. That's why Krishna is asking us to remember him all the time. So that's what Krishna is saying, that is the only way you can come to me. So be a devotee. So become my devotee. Manmana bhava madbhakto. Always think of me, become my devotee. That's what madbhakto, become my devotee. So then why Krishna is asking us to become his devotee? Then we can know Krishna as he is. Then we can enter into Krishna's abode. We can go to Goloka. So by Krishna's causeless mercy, we have successfully finished this sloka number 53 in the 11th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. 54 in the 11th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. We have one more sloka to finish this 11th chapter, Viswarupam. Hare Krishna, I will stop now and we'll discuss if any questions are there. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna Prabhu, Siva Prabhu.